Hi everybody, I'm Jack and this is Raw Tropical Living. Thanks for joining me today. Coming to you from a beautiful, beautiful sunny day here in Lower Alabama. It's a Tuesday. My mom's got somebody here to clean the house in a little bit, so I'm going to get a few things done and get out and about. Get outside the house, move around a little bit. I've already been getting a little bit of work done this morning, working on the store. Almost have all the new designs uploaded. Hopefully I'll have some links, like I said, by middle or later part of this week. Anyhow, I wanted to talk today about the raw vegan lifestyle and how I know and why I feel that it's optimal for me. I do videos every day on the raw vegan lifestyle, on just a plant-based diet in general, a little bit of sometimes on my meditation practice, a little bit of fitness, a little bit of this and that. So if you're not already subscribed, I'd appreciate if you'd hit that subscribe button now. Click on the little bell and check send notifications so you'll stay subscribed to the channel. I trust my body. I trust my instincts. I trust how I feel with things. But I kind of temper that with also with education and with learning a bit. So I just wanted to kind of say that before I get into this message here, because sometimes people have... when they hear you say, oh, I just go by how I listen to what my body tells me to, they kind of consider that kind of woo-woo advice. And I can kind of see where that comes from. And also, too, your mileage may vary depending on how long you've been doing this lifestyle. I would say, before I get into telling you why I believe it works for me, I would say as far as listening to your body and doing what you do based on how you feel, there's a learning period in there. There's a learning curve in the beginning, because in the beginning, you're not even sure how to, like, in my opinion, you're not even quite sure how to listen to your body. So you can't just, you don't know what signs or what things to listen for or what to look for. So in the beginning, it's a little bit less. Like, you have to really, you do have to rely on education. You have to learn how to do this lifestyle, how to eat a plant-based lifestyle in general to get everything that we need to get to be healthy, to get all the nutrients in there. But I would say that very early on in your process, even from day one, as you're starting to educate yourself and you're starting to learn things, do like I do. Treat yourself as an experiment. Treat this body as a laboratory. Pay close attention. Listen, okay. First of all, I know just from my lifestyle, you know, being single, no kids, no mortgage, no wife, no responsibilities really. I have lots of time to kind of experiment with these things, and I have lots of time to focus on and be aware of it. Some people don't have, that much time to be introspective with it, but I would say from the very beginning as you're doing this, be very aware of your body. Be very aware of everything about your body. And pay attention. Just pay attention and pay attention to subtle changes. Pay attention to how eating differently affects your body differently. What I'm getting at here is I'm very intuitive. I listen. I really tune in. And you know, hey, I'm not saying by any means, and that's what I'm always very cautious about. I'm not saying, oh, I'm there. I'm not saying I've figured it out. I've gotten there. This is it. I feel great now, so I can just, put everything on autopilot and move forward and expect everything to be perfect for the rest of my life. Because, as I've mentioned in a number of videos, you can't go totally by how you feel right now, because there's a number of stories out there of raw vegans who, 5 years in feel great, 6 years in feel great, 7, 8 years in feel great. And then all of a sudden, and it can come after a number of years, like something goes wrong, like some deficiency, some major hole in their nutrition, I guess, is revealed. And, you kind of figure out, okay, I've been neglecting something or something isn't working. So I'm never saying, I'm there and this is it. This is how things will be for the rest of my life. But for right now, I feel pretty darn good. And I don't think my body would fool me. Like I say, when it comes to this type stuff, people say, well, maybe you're imagining this or you can't go totally by that. But the criteria I'm using, I believe I would be a fool to, I believe I would be a fool to adjust what I'm doing or adapt how I eat, adapt how I live, and go against how my body feels and what my body is telling me. Now, and if you remember, and hey, maybe compare me to some of the other all vegan folks out there, the YouTubers or whatever. You got to say, I experiment a lot. So I go from eating, I've eaten cooked, you know, when I'm in the States. I've eaten cooked, you know, on the road. So I eat a variety, and I pay very close attention to how my body changes when I eat like this cooked and when I eat this cooked, you know, when I eat heavier things. So I'm always experimenting. And also too, just to put this in perspective, because sometimes I think there's people out there that I don't know that they necessarily have street cred in this type thing, because it's almost like if you've been clean your whole life, or if you've been clean since you were 20 something years old, you don't have as much perspective to compare it against. See, I've done it all. I'm 53 years old. I came to this lifestyle when I was 48. So I've got a lot to compare it to. So it's not just like, oh, I feel a little better, so I know. I know that now at 53, I feel absolutely the best I felt ever in my life. And I don't mean just a little bit. I mean like magnified 10 times. Now, I have eaten horribly. I was a drunk. I drank like a fish, and at times would go through periods of eating very, very bad, you know, just tons of animal products, tons of fat, tons of grease, chicken wings, just pounds of meat. Just imagine as bad as you can eat. I've eaten that for periods of time, just fried chicken, you know. I remember days where I could eat 6 or 7 pieces of fried chicken, a pizza, just some nasty stuff. Okay. Also, just for somebody that might say, well, but you know, because there's always that argument, well, you can't compare because nobody, yeah, that's a trashy lifestyle, but what if I eat a little bit healthier? Well, I've eaten a healthier version of the standard American diet. I've mentioned that a number of times too. So it's not all, my backstory isn't one of just like going from the gutter to way up here. I've been in between too. I've done that kind of what I used to consider healthy, where I've cut back, you know, where I stopped the drinking, I cut back on the animal products. I was, you know, eating lower fat, I was exercising. So I wasn't eating as bad a version of the standard American diet. In fact, in a lot of ways, I was doing a lot of healthy things. I was eating, I was eating a lot of fruit. I was eating fruit in the morning a lot. A lot of times I'd eat fruit till noon. Lots of smoothies, lots of salads, lots of vegetables in there. So I've done it at that really garbage, just the garbage way of living, eating junk, eating, you know, out of cans, eating whatever. I've eaten at that where you were consciously thinking you ate healthy, thinking you ate clean at the time. And also too, as on plant-based, I've gone through the spectrum. You know, I've had cooked food mixed in there, and I've eaten very high raw. I've eaten fully raw for long, long periods of time. So I have something to compare. I have a base there that I can compare from. And I can just tell you without a doubt. Now, like I always say, I don't harp on this fully raw thing. I'm not like one of these raw is law, cooked food is poison, this and that. But I always do want to clarify that I do feel my absolute best on fully raw. When I'm eating all raw, I do feel the best. My energy level is the absolute best. Digestion, for sure. For sure, for sure, for sure, for sure. I can really feel the subtleties in different things I'm eating with my digestion. Now, once again, I don't want to like be drastic or exaggerate there. It doesn't, if I go from, by eating fully raw to eating something cooked, like say, for instance, my typical meal when I eat cooked is usually sweet potatoes and some sort of a green. It'll either be sweet potatoes and collard greens or sweet potatoes, and I'll steam these kind of stir-fry vegetables and eat it with that. I don't see a huge change in the digestion, but I do see a little bit of a slowing in the digestion, and I also feel like to keep my digestion going the same as it was, I need to drink a lot of water. So I do feel those subtleties, and I do feel my absolute best. When I'm eating 100% raw, I feel my best. My energy level is through the roof. I've got plenty of energy to work out. I've got plenty energy to repair. A lot of it for me has, like I say, has just been on figuring out how much I need to eat. People are always going back and forth. Well, I couldn't do the raw thing. To me, it's about eating enough and eating the right amount of food. Really, the whole cooked versus raw has had very little to do with it for me, as far as the ease of doing this lifestyle. It was just like, once I kind of dialed in, found recipes I like, found the amount of calories I need, boom, that was it. But what I would say is just to kind of finish up with some thoughts here, is tune into that. Now, just because I'm saying that, I'm not telling, the message of this video is not like everybody go fully raw or everybody do like me, because this is how I feel. All I'm really encouraging you to do is to tune into your own body, listen to your own body, and be objective. Listen with an open mind. Don't listen with conclusions. If you will totally open yourself up with no prejudices in there, like going into the experiment thinking like raw vegan's not the way to go, or going into the experiment thinking, yep, raw is the only way, but just going in and eating and taking that data without any emotion, without any prejudgment on it, just go by how you feel. Experiment a little bit. If you are eating some cooked food, experiment with how you're eating that cooked food. Experiment with eating fully raw. If you've never, listen, don't knock fully raw if you've never actually even done it before for any sort of a period of time, and if you haven't put in any of the effort to do it the proper way and get everything that you need in there. Now, once again, maybe it's not your interest to be fully raw, and then, well, why did you make it to this point of the video? Because you're not really interested in that. Or maybe you're interested in the tone, the thought of the video, but I would just always say, and to wrap up, in the beginning, educate, educate, educate. Read, read. Get a variety of opinions. Get conflicting opinions. Figure out why they're conflicting, and continuously, as you go on and on, educate yourself. But as you get this knowledge base inside, start applying that, and start including your body in the decision making. Let it decide. Let it tell you, no, this just isn't right. I just don't feel quite right on this. And yeah, that your body's not going to lead you astray. So anyhow, that's why I do what I do. It doesn't have to anything to do with this whole little, YouTube world, or being one of the cool kids, or wanting to be part of this group, or being part of that group, or I get along better with this group. It's all about how I feel from day to day and what I'm learning and how I'm evolving. But anyhow, just my 2 cents worth. Hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you like it, please give me a thumbs up. Share me from time to time, and I will see you guys again tomorrow. Love you lots. Peace.